So this is a quick, very rough video to help you guys have a little bit of a better understanding for how we can depict the magnetic field around a long straight wire. And because it's an inherently three-dimensional thing, it is a little bit difficult to picture on a flat screen or flat piece of paper. Now, in addition to my graphic that I have right over there, I've got a 3D model here. And again, this is kind of rough. But the important thing to understand is that as the current is going, the magnetic field forms a loop around it. So in this particular case, on both diagrams, I've got the current in a long straight wire going up the board. Then you have to use your right hand, and that right hand is going to help you have a view of what's happening with the magnetic field. Now that thumb, mine doesn't wrap around quite as easily here, but your thumb has to stay pointed up, and the direction your fingers go tells you it comes in over there, it goes across the wire, and then you can imagine it wraps around and comes back out on this side. So it comes out, wraps around, and goes in. Now over on a graphic, what we have is we actually have the thumb represented here, and sometimes we can draw this kind of curved arrow. And again, you're imagining that this is a flat loop that you're looking at sort of from the side. So again, it shows where it comes out, goes across, and goes in, just like this one did over here. Now, where the magnetic field is going in, it's like we're seeing the tail side of the arrow, so that's why we use X's. And over here where the magnetic field is coming out, that's like where we see the head of the arrows. And so we show that as just dots. Now over here in this figure, it's actually a little bit misleading because the graphic I had the X's evenly spaced and the dots evenly spaced. But it won't quite be that way. So I'm gonna real quick here add some little things. And remember that as you're closer to the wire, you're going to have magnetic field, which is stronger. But then as you move away, it's going to be a little weaker. And so that means our arrows here are going to be further spaced apart. And so I've shown that with X's that are more dense in close to the wire and then getting less dense as I go further away. On the side where it's coming out over here, that's where I'd see the head of the arrows. So again, real quick here, showing you that you would have stronger magnetic field in closer to the wire. And then as you move further away, they're going to get less dense. And so you would end up having wires which are spread, or not wires, but symbols and dots that are spread further apart. If I temporarily take off my little magnet part here, again, where it's coming out, you would have the dots, because that's the head of the arrow. Where it's going in, you'd have the X's, and that's the back side of the arrow. It's always going to be stronger near the wire, but uniform along the wire, and then getting weaker as you get further and further out. And again, using our right hand rule, the direction of where it's going in and where it's coming out is given by your thumb. Now, of course, if my current was going in a different direction, we can see that the magnetic field actually follows that diagram. So by having my nice little sheet here, I can turn it at any direction I need to. And if my thumb were going in the direction of the current, I'd still see the direction that the magnetic field is. And I apologize, it's hard for me to turn my thumb in the right direction in the video camera where I can't quite see everything. But that should help give you a little bit of a better view for what's happening with that magnetic field in three dimensions, where you've got that magnetic field wrapping around the wire. Hopefully this helped you more than it confused you.